Hello, bonjour, and welcome to your new Bonner Private Wines video. I'm your host, Julien, and this is a relatively short video to introduce you to the wines that we've cherry-picked, tasting tins and tins of wines from the biggest winemaking country in the world, special wines that we truly loved from France, that form our new quarterly wine club selection release. Here they are, the six wines that you have been waiting for. I've decided that rather than making a long video explaining all of these wines at once in one long video, as I've been doing before for the Italians and the Argentinians, I would do one video for each of those wines. So that's what I did. So you have individual videos, individual clips that will introduce you to each of these cuvées, where they come from, the story of the makers, the people that make them, the land that has cropped, that has grown those vines. And let me spoil it, all of those wines are made by small passionate wine growers, and all of them taste rather good. But you also have in those videos my tasting notes, my impressions, so you have a better understanding of the style that you should expect. You will have my food pairing suggestions, and also whether you should hold on to those wines for a few years or enjoy them rather soon. This way, when you're ready to learn about one of those wines, you can easily watch the corresponding video and learn it all there. But let me give you a quick roundup of what you will find in this exclusive selection. So first you have a rosé wine. Well, why a rosé? One, because this type of pale, dry rosé wine from the south of France is truly part of the wine culture in France, and it's perfect to go with food as well, which is part of the French wine culture, right? And it's fantastic for simple enjoyment with friends and family. Secondly, we've included this rosé because this one is a particularly delicious example and particularly well made, and we really had to make to have you discover it. But more about it in the corresponding video, like for all of those wines. Then you have four different reds. Two of the reds are in a little bit of a lighter style, even though you'll see that because they are crafted with such care in such great wine countries on such great terroir, they are still pretty dense and very complex. But they are wines that are more driven by the fruity characters, the freshness and vibrant expression of the grapes they were made from, and wines to be drunk a little bit younger, while you see the other two are to be cellared and can be aged for longer. So you have a Cabernet Franc, which is a grape related to Cabernet Sauvignon, but that has more finesse and elegance to it. It's smooth and textural, but more floral and vibrantly fruity than most big Cabernet Sauvignons that you can find. Fresher flavors of mixed red berries than most cabs that you've probably ever tasted, I'm sure. And then you have a wine that comes from Beaujolais, more perhaps of a Pinot Noir style of wine, even though it's made from another grape that is called Gamay. This particular one is made from very old vines made by a woman winemaker that crops the vineyards and that makes the wines herself with her hands. She puts all of her heart into making this wine, and you can see that she even puts her heart on the label. A wine I am very, very fond of. Then you have two red wines from two of the most prestigious and famous appellations in France, because you deserve no less. First, you will have a Châteauneuf du Pape from the southern Rhone Valley of France, a rich and very textural wine, very spicy, dense, and also powerful. And a wine from Saint-Emilion in the Bordeaux region, from the very illustrious, famous wine village of Saint-Emilion. And this is a Grand Cru wine on top of that, so an excellent example of a very, very good Bordeaux wine. It's dense, it's deep, it's fantastic to drink now to experience what a great Bordeaux tastes like, but it's also one that you can age at well 10 years, 20 years if you want, and it's really, really superb. Finally, you have, of course, a champagne wine. There couldn't be a French wine selection without a very good champagne. And this Moutard Champagne in particular is also made by a relatively small producer that makes it with incredible, incredible passion from their own vineyard. So most champagne wines that you can buy, that you find at your local wine shop, will be made by large champagne houses that buy a lot of grapes from all around the region to growers that grow their own vineyards. But this particular champagne producer crop their own grapes on their own vineyards, on their own terroir that has been in the family for many, many centuries, for 9 generations in fact. So this is a really, really special champagne, and I'll let you discover more about it in that individual video that I made about it. Overall, I think this is quite an amazing Tour de France of French wines that you've got here. You will see how different those wines are, and each of them have their own style, their own flavors, their own identity, especially if you listen to the backstory of them. So it's really going to take you on a journey all around France, a tasting journey, tasting some of the best wine styles the country has to offer. I mean, I am French and I've tasted many, many wines from here, and if given to taste these 6 wines, only these 6 wines from France, or even if I could only live and drink 6 wines in the entire world out of everything, if I was on a desert island or something, no more, I think I would be very, very happy with those, because they are so different, yet they are so well crafted, each individually and respectively. So I'll leave you to tasting all of these wines and discover more in these other individual videos, and I will see you soon in the wonderful world of wine. Au revoir, bye bye, cheers.